just as I conclude, I'll tell you their story.
It was in
Loni again, and we were just going around this place, and then this young woman came to me, and she said that there's this particular center which I would like you to see, and see what you can do for it. So this was, can you put the girls back? Yeah. They're cute, na? So they said that, would you visit this center? And this center is, what happens over there is a lot of young women are married off very early in life. 14 years, 12 years, pretty average age for marriage, tribals. And often these people live up the hills and pretty poor economic conditions. They marry down to truck drivers who operate trucks, the drivers of trucks, who would be twice or thrice their age. So 30, 40-year-old man marrying a 14-year-old girl, not uncommon. And but that's not ironical. The problem is that in many, many cases, these truck drivers is very ill. And Leela wants to be Miss India. Both of them are HIV positive. That's it. Thank you. So thank you. Thank you for your time. I don't know whether we can take questions. We can take questions. Wonderful. So while I have overshot by about, she's very kind. Yeah. So any questions which you have? I'll be able to take only two questions because I've got a flight at 1 o'clock. I have to go to Kolkata.
How do you classify Chambal?
How do I classify Chambal? How do I classify Chambal? Okay.
See,
Chambal is a large area towards the southeast part of UP, right? And goes into MP as well. And Chambal is basically, you imagine an area which has got, it's very dry, not because of rainfall, but because of the geographical condition, the water flows like this, you know? And the soil is very clay kind of. So it does not absorb, water does not recharge the ground.
Devi Mandir.
Achha, achha.
So, and my question is, like, how you decide to adopt that particular village or block for Pura initiative? What basic ingredients you like to know before you?
No, see, there is, see, what basic ingredients I need to know? There is no selection policy for Pura. I mean, everyone needs, we need 7,000 Puras across 600,000 villages. So there's no selection policy. But what is required, I'll tell you. You need a local champion. You need a local agency, institution, person of influence who needs to take it up, because otherwise you can't thrust models upon people. That has been happening for 60 years now, one after the other, one after the other. You have to do a local kind of an implementation. The other thing is what you need to know is you need to know, for example, I'll give you an example. We teach at IIM Indore, Dr. Kalam goes there, and we had a group of 200 students who visited the state of Madhya Pradesh across its length and breadth. 19 districts they went to and came up with a researched model based on the what kind of competencies are there in the villages and what are the core needs which could lead to the flourishing of these competencies. So 19 districts they went, they produced about 50 plans. If any of one of you is interested, then I can forward you those plans. They're bright students, MBA students who have not just graduated and they did this something. So this is what we do. There's no selection criteria. There's no application
Thank
or
you.
Something, right? Yeah, this is the last question I'll take because you stood up, so I'll take the question.
It was very nice to discuss because there was this NCUS which was formed a couple of years back.
Mm-hmm.
And then it, it was formed on the same concept of having the Pura, and that was with the state government. So we have actually prepared a DPR. Mm-hmm. And then nothing happened. So I wonder what is the next step.
So that's what happens. Right? DPLs are prepared and nothing happens. This is a common story. However, to the credit of a lot of government efforts, the MORD, the Ministry of Rural Development, in combination with the three or four other departments, including the Alternative Energy Department, has now rolled out the Pura scheme across 9 states. Dr. Kalam was talking about it. There's a Meenakshi Mission Pura, which is less than 5 villages now, about 5 villages. So this is just fledgling. But what we want to do, how to link them is a good question. And that is what Pura Activated will do. Pura Activated as a separate entity will collect. See, you have to give them independence. You can't play around with people's independence. Let them do independently, but they can share a common brand, first up. They can share technology. They can share ideas. You know, why the Samarkshit Dampati can be applied, the SSD, the rural sculptures. That model is so brilliant. You can apply it not just across the Puras, across any scheme. That is the kind of model which we need. Even for an REGA, the Rozgar Sahayaks can learn a lot from these people. So there has to be sharing of ideas. Brand, ideas, technology. Three things.
Mr. Singh, having followed Mr. President Kalam after his presidency for quite some time, and I've been following Pura also for the last few years, it's a little depressing when you said about this rural urban divide that you'd actually define rural thing. And we are already kind of dividing urban and rural populations here. And I think a lot of solutions for the rural population lies in the urban setup, and a lot of solutions in the urban population lies in the rural setup, and vice versa. And I just want to ask you, for me, Bombay is an overgrown village, you know, by your definition of 1 lakh or 2 lakhs, or whatever you put in. I'm not a technician, I'm not an analyst, but it's very common sense that, when we make these divides and we say that we are different from the rural population, that itself cuts down the approach to a solution, because I think we as consumers as much have a role to play in rural development as much as the rural people as producers have a role to play. So where do you see this kind of involvement or your approach to involve the so-called urban population into the solution that you have?
Okay, very good question. Now, first is that many of the people I work with and I am friends with are actually from rural areas. So it's not just, we are consumers of rural areas. We are in some way, at some generation, we belong to villages. So that is one connectivity of the spirit. But how do you contribute? And that is what Pura Activated is trying to do. We are trying to create contributions in three manners. One is through investment, which is sustainable investment, not charity. Knowledge, you can give them knowledge. You know markets, right? You work in industry. You see what Mumbai needs and what abroad needs, what export requirements are, what quality standards are coming, what are the best technologies which are coming out. Those kind of things. Can you help them with those things? You can just contribute by your knowledge. And the third is, as you said, a lot of the urban areas are actually consumers of rural products, which is true. So can we create linkages for quality rural products, markets for quality rural products across a brand of Pura, where the rural area ensures quality. Make them ensure quality. We have to do that. The quality has to be there, otherwise the national economy will not flourish. And create a market for that quality processed goods in India, across India, and even abroad. Can we create that kind of model? I'll give you an example quickly. There's one of the things which we are doing in Varna, one of the Pura models. In Varna, it's in Maharashtra, near Kolhapur. So, and if you are aware, in Mumbai, there's a Varna Dood which comes, milk in the name of Varna, exactly the same place. And what they're doing, they have a sugar, cooperative sugar factory, which has been set up. And what they did was that someone gave them a knowledge intelligence that, look, Pepsi aata hai, cola aata hai, fruity aata hai, sab cheeze aati hai. Why not sugarcane juice should be processed, packaged, flavored, and sold? And they're coming out this product. Someone gave them knowledge. And that guy also helped them establish a brand outside India, in UAE. So they'll be exporting packaged sugarcane juice, flavored packaged sugarcane juice, which is novel. I don't think I've seen it anywhere. This is the first time it's going to come to outside markets. That's one thing which you can do. So this is how you can contribute, right? So shall we move? You write to me. Write an email. Okay, thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Shijan. In fact, Shijan, I have to tell you a small anecdote about when we invited you to Sankalp. If you are familiar with the other things that IntelliCap does, we also run a financial inclusion forum similar to Sankalp but focused on financial inclusion called Shijan. So we were very kicked about the fact that Shijan is coming to Sankalp. As a small token of our appreciation, Shijan, there's a small memento for you.
Thank you. That's real time.
Technology. Thank you very much, Shijan.